Deep down in us, we find what makes us function, what makes us human, our proteins. And now, we're seeing them like we've never seen them before. Every day, without pause, the heart pumps 7,500 liters of blood through our bodies. It's the engine of our blood circulatory system, and it makes sure our cells get the oxygen and nutrients they need. But the heart itself also needs oxygen, and when that supply is cut off, it can have devastating effects. Within the Human Protein Atlas project, all of the different proteins in the human body are being mapped out. And all this is available on the HPA Open Access website. Here, researchers can study the proteins that keep our hearts beating. And now, this is being taken even further with a new technique that allows researchers to explore our proteins in three dimensions.
The heart is an amazing muscle, and seeing it like this opens up a whole new world.
Images like these make it possible for Peder Olofsson to improve our understanding of what makes hearts tick.
Deoxygenated blood from the body is transported through veins, and here it enters the right atrium and then continues into the right ventricle. When the right ventricle contracts, blood is pumped through the lungs, where oxygen and carbon dioxide are exchanged. The freshly oxygenated blood then enters the left atrium, continues into the left ventricle, where the blood then leaves the heart into the aorta and continues out in the body. The heart is always active and requires a constant supply of energy, delivered by blood in the coronary arteries, here visualized in red, together with an extensive network of nerves, shown in green. This extensive network of blood vessels originates from the aorta and supplies the heart muscle with oxygen and energy.
But when the flow of blood is obstructed, it can cause an infarction.
A myocardial infarction is a potentially life-threatening condition which occurs when the blood flow is interrupted and cardiac cells die. This is commonly caused by a blood clot in an artery where a plaque has formed. These plaques can build up over decades, and the condition causes many deaths worldwide. The ability to visualize in three dimensions how the arterial tree interacts with cells and molecules helps us imagine novel aspects of its function. Perhaps there are aspects that were overlooked that now become apparent in three dimensions. For example, the arterial tree in the heart is closely intertwined with a network of nerves, and the potential interactions between the blood vessels and the nerves is a relationship that requires much further exploration. When it comes to myocardial infarction, it's very important to understand the arteries and their environment in the heart. This technique of visualization may help us improve our ability to diagnose, monitor and treat cardiovascular diseases.
When we explore the world in new ways, we discover new things about us, about life itself. And now we see our proteins like we've never seen them before.